So you're trying to stop spending so much money on your hobby. You should probably watch this video and then unsubscribe, but I'll get back to that later.
If checking your bank account gives you anxiety, or if your shelf of opportunity is larger than many people's collections, you might be like me. And if you are like me, what makes me feel better? A brand new shiny board game. Ah, the cycle continues. What if I told you there is a way to enjoy this hobby without getting a second mortgage on your home? You need to make some changes. Some are in your head, and others are actionable and extremely easy. Number one, set realistic expectations. You can buy board games, but you cannot buy time. This is one that I struggle with more than most of these. I buy these games or acquire these games with grandiose plans of playing them with my friends and family, and frankly, my shelf of opportunity just continued and continued to grow, and most of them wouldn't see the light of day when we did play games that was stuff we already knew. Learning games is hard and introducing them is harder. Set realistic expectations for yourself. Do not buy a game if you don't think you're gonna be able to table it. Do not buy a game if you do not see your friend group enjoying it. Do not buy a game if you have 18 other games on your shelf of opportunity. It's simple time management, and I'm really poor at it. This might be a spicy one, and I'll admit I still do this and likely will continue to do it, but I'll be much more strict about it in the future. Don't back Kickstarters. Don't Kickstart or crowdfund board games. Not only are they oftentimes more expensive, you have the secondhand market. They take 2 years to deliver. Sometimes they never deliver. The shipping situation right now is absurd, and that's not a blame on the publisher one bit, but right now is not a good time to buy Kickstarter. So if you're trying to curb your spending, that's a great place to start. As I sit in front of my 5x5 Kallax, an excellent way to curb your spending is to give yourself less space. Turn that 5x5 into a 4x4, maybe even a 2x2. If you give yourself less space, you have less room to acquire. This is one that I struggle with. Not only do I have a 5x5, I have a 2x2. I have a giant ping pong table right behind the camera that stores prototypes, giveaway games, games I'm culling. And if I did not have that, or if I did not have this shelf, I wouldn't have room for these games. I'd be forced to make stricter decisions and cull more regularly so I can have space for the games that I do actually want. I say that as there's also a dozen games sitting on the fireplace next to me as well. I need to be more careful about the space. I need to stop giving myself this space to live in. I need to take that space back, reclaim it as my own, and not as a bunch of Kickstarters and board games. This one is a little less easy to complete, and not everyone can do this, but find a local group. If you can, if there's a scene in your area, if you can find a group that already has board games, that have the 5x5 Kallaxes, you don't need to buy as many. Don't buy duplicates. If someone has a copy, don't get it. I have a copy of Dwellings of Eldervale that I'm attempting to cull because I know two people, granted we don't play that often, but I know two people that own the Legendary Edition. I don't need this game. It's not one that I have to have. I'd like to play it, and when I do, I'll schedule a time to play it with them. I don't need to own it. It takes up a ton of space. It's a pretty penny for a game, and I don't need to be the third person in town to own Dwellings of Eldervale. Now, even if you don't have a local group, I assure you, you can still try games before you buy them. We are living in a wealth of opportunities right now for that with Tabletopia, Tabletop Simulator, Board Game Arena. There are plenty of resources out there for you to try a game before you actively spend money on it. Of course, Max, it's not the same. It's not the same. I know, it's not. You're absolutely right. But it should still be enough of an experience to tell you whether you should actively pursue that game or not. If I play a few rounds of Lost Ruins of Arnak on Board Game Arena and I think, man, this is incredible, I'll put it on my wish list. If I don't really love it, easy. That's a game I don't need to buy right then and there. Try before you buy, if at all possible. This is one that I stink at, and Doolin as well. We actually just had this conversation in our Discord yesterday. By the way, Discord link in the description. Stop worrying about free shipping.
What?
There's a place that we can order from where you have to hit $125 to get free shipping. Or you could have it shipped to store and pick it up an hour away on a trip that I usually take every couple of weeks. Not for the store, I just drive by it and can stop in and get something. It's not worth it. You will end up buying games that you actively don't care about. You may be interested in them, but they're not ones that you really, really wanna buy, or you wouldn't be scrolling to page 125 trying to find a game to fill up your cart. We were sitting at $75 and I could not think of 50 to get us to that free shipping. And for once in my life, I stopped. I didn't just throw a few things in the cart because, hey, it's a good deal, free shipping. No, I didn't do it because it isn't worth it. Save your money, spend $12 on shipping instead of $50 on games that you actively don't care about. You all know me, and this is one I'm not bad at. Do not be afraid to cull or sell your board games. You don't need to hold on to every single game you've ever owned. If you're not playing them, get rid of them. If they don't bring you joy, get rid of them. I just sold Catan yesterday. I loved Catan. It was one of my first entries into the hobby, but I didn't play it. Did it sting a little when I got rid of it? Sure, it stung a little, but it's not a big deal. It made me money, it got room on my shelf, and it got out of my sight. I'm happy, and I'm making someone else happy by selling them a game for a good deal. Now, this last one, I don't really want you to do. In fact, I actively encourage you to do the opposite if you like what you see here, but it's a really good idea to curb your spending. Unsubscribe from your favorite YouTubers. Click that unsubscribe button, take the bookmark for Board Game Geek and Amazon and Card House and YouTube off your webpage. If you're not actively seeking out game content, you're more likely to look at your own shelf and try and get experiences that way, instead of seeing the next best thing or top fives or must buys, which there are no must buys, by the way. But instead of actively seeking out content that makes you excited and interested in games, instead just turn that dial off. Turn us off, shut us out. It might hurt my feelings, but it may do you good. You may spend less money by not seeing my top five lists if I have that kind of clout. I'm not gonna plug any videos on my channel because they're probably actively encouraging you to buy things. So if this is you, if you wanna stop buying things, exit now. But otherwise, check out the channel. See if there's anything else you like.